Hey everybody, Troa here. Gonna go ahead and do a little bit of a Space Engineers series. Now, if you guys have seen any of my Space Engineers videos that I've done in the past, they are, well, massive. And the world has been going on for almost a year now in that world. So, it's really hard actually to do a kind of YouTube series for that world because those projects have been, they're massive. They take forever to do anything on, and if I did one now, it would be in the middle of something and you'd have no backstory or anything else like that. And I've been trying to figure out a way I can actually like put out some Space Engineers content now for a while. And I've decided that I'm just going to go ahead and start over. I'm just going to go ahead and make a new world and start from scratch. Survival. It's got mods in it because I like mods. That's my decision. But if you guys have any other mods that you want to see or add to it, I've already got quite a few in here. Ones that I really like, just to name a few, some of the skins, Sage's survival, Sage's industrial thruster, which I freaking love. That is an amazing mod. Looks good, works well. The works. As far as, putting credit and actually having a list of all the mods that are in here, that might get a little tedious. I'll see if I can do that though. I'd like to get them all to where you can just click on them from the annotations, or not annotations, but in the description of the video. That'll be something that might take a while, and I'm going to get the content out there first, and then retroactively put that in there. That way we can actually put some content out there, because there's a lot that goes on behind the scenes in making these videos. So I hope you guys enjoyed this series. Let me know what you think. I'm just going to kind of do what I do here. If you have any suggestions, let me know. But yeah, as you can tell, I've got a skybox in here. This is one of my favorite skyboxes. I used to use it a lot, and I figured, well, why not? I'll put it in this one. Now, this series is largely, and hopefully not entirely, going to be in single player, but it might have some multiplayer aspects, or at least some guest appearances every now and then from friends of mine and everything else like that. So we'll see. We'll see how that goes out. But let's go ahead and get this one started. So as you guys can see here, I've started in a survival pod with normal asteroids, four of them, with a slight limit size to the world with cargo ships and everything else. So I'm going to go ahead and find me an asteroid to call home. But the first thing I'm going to do, since I can... Oh, damper's rough. Okay, there we go. Is I'm going to go in here and I'm going to turn off my gravity generator. And that saves a lot of fuel right off the bat. So that first... I don't know. This looks like it's going to have a lot of stuff in it. But that asteroid over there looks interesting. So I'm going to go over there and see what that's all about. Because that one over there to the left also looks good too. That guy over there. But we'll see. We'll see. I mean, you know, these are all of them. So, figure out what's going on here. Kind of looks like a mass drive from, or an FTL drive from Mass Effect. Looks pretty cool, actually. So see how it looks like when I get closer to it and it renders in properly. Kind of want to crash the ship. I don't think I'll do that, though. I don't know if this is really going to have anything I want on it. It's a cool-looking asteroid, though. I don't think that's actually going to have any material that I want. I don't know. I kind of like that, but I'm thinking I'm going to go ahead and go to another one here. There we go. There's another one over there like this one. I don't know. I was thinking about making a station in this one rather than a base on an asteroid, because that's been done a million times. So I think I would do something a little bit different that way. I mean, that's going to take a while. I need to get, you know, some fuel and everything. Because right now I'm just burning fuel for no reason. Yeah, this looks like it's going to have all the resources I need. So I'm going to stop here for a while and do a little bit of a pit stop, if you will. Yeah, there we go. This is definitely going to have what I need on it. So, let's go ahead and get a little bit closer, and I'll show you guys a little bit of tips and tricks, because I've been playing survival for a while, and I happen to know a few of them. So, first things first, let's get this nice and close. Now, these episodes, I'm going to try to get them to where they're only about 30 minutes long, that way that makes it a little bit easier to edit and everything else like that. And we'll go from there. This first one might be a little bit longer, though, because I'm getting started. And all of my settings are turned up to maximum because this is a YouTube series. If I want something that's realistic and takes forever to do, I'll do that in my own time. So, first thing, let me go ahead and turn this back on. But let me change the height. And let's put this down. There we go, that's about right. And then let's move that down, there we go. Oh, apparently I didn't turn it on. There we go. By the way, it's always easier to get out of this door when you have gravity, because otherwise it's just everybody hates that door. Alright, so there we go. And as you can see, I have some mods here. Just a few. Actually quite a bit. But these I like these a lot. So, actually, I'm going to get rid of that one. But, yeah, I got the NASA blocks mod. I got some interior stuff because I like some of the blocks, like the pipes and everything else like that. Oh, he made a single bed. Cool. Wing mods for when I build fighters. And the sniper rifle, again, for capturing ships. I don't know why. Okay, I don't know why it's in there twice. I only put the one in there. I got some of these. I got those. I got these. And I love the carbon blocks, and I love all the slanted, and I love all the logistics mods and everything else like that, because then it, you know, it feels a little bit better. And these guys are awesome. I love the laser welders. They are awesome. So good job on that. And I got these ones in because I can make the ships look a little bit better, but that's me. So yeah, that's what I got in here so far as mods. But that's starting to look a mess. But anyway, let's go ahead and there we go. That's what I'm after. So, that one on 7, this one on 8, and this one on 9, please. Thank you. Alright, so, if you guys can tell, I have gravity. And what that allows me to do is very easily mine things without really having to worry about anything. So, just as an example, if I go here and do that, okay, you always got to remember which one's actually real when the little things go off. I need to adjust that. Okay. There we go. And I just kind of hold down T and spin around in a circle to get my initial kind of bearings here. Build a little catch for all of my ore, you know, where things are going to be going. And then go from there and just try to pick up everything as I go along. And this makes it incredibly easy. Now, I don't really care what I'm picking up right now, because, like, magnesium. I don't need magnesium right now at all. But I'm going to get it largely because I can. I really don't have to worry about it. I can have it. I can refine it if I want to. I can throw it in the cargo container. I mean, I really don't have to refine it. I'm going to, though, because I'm comfortable with the amount of uranium I have. However, if you're new to this game, the first thing you need to do is get uranium. Always, if you're new. If you're comfortable with, you know, messing around like I am, it doesn't really matter. But I'm going to put some of that in there right now, get that going. And I guess I should play it closer as though you're a newer player. So I'm going to go in here. Hello. Okay. I'm not used to autosave. I turn it off in my world. All right. Well, let's go find some uranium. So let's see here, actually. Let's get up here. I'm going to run and jump out. and then just drag my face across the asteroid till I find some uranium. Let's see, any uranium? Uranium, silver, iron, silver, silver again. Cobalt. It's gonna be useful later. Iron, uranium, here we go. Does it dip down again? No, it doesn't seem to. Alright, do a little bit of right-clicking there so I can kind of see where this is going to be. I'm doing some regular mining right now just to throw some stone up in the air. And what that's doing for me is it's letting me know where this is in relation to my ship, which is over there. Okay, see, there's the floating stone, so now I know. It is over this way. And there we go, there's the little hole that I drilled with the stone sticking out of it, so I'm just going to go back over there. And there we go. The stones fell back in. Park this thing pretty close. I mean, pretty close. There we go. Get on out of there, and I'm going to do a couple more things. So, I need construction components, so what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to get some of those. I'm going to go in here, and I'm going to go ahead and put... Actually, I don't really need to do what I was about to do, but I'll show you anyway. So I'll go out here to the assembler, right? And I'll put those in there, production, and I will disassemble that iron. Right? And then I can assemble some construction components. So let's put 10 in there. There we go. So now I have some construction components that I made from the iron in the floor. That's one way you can kind of save yourself a little bit of trouble. And you don't have to necessarily produce construction components. But the reason why I did that is I'm going to go ahead and put some lights on the bottom of this thing. Because all they require is construction components. There we go. Now I can go over here and then take the last 6 lights that I added. So lights, and then there we go. And I'm just going to turn up their radius and their intensity. Give them a little bit more fall off so I can increase that and that. There we go. Nah, I don't want them blowing up, but there we go. Now we got a nice bright working area. Gravity. I can just kind of set right down in here, and the uranium is off this way, so let's go after it. Again, just kind of hold down T while I'm doing this, and kind of spin around in a circle, making it to where I can get towards this. Okay, go back up here, and just go over here. Now, I don't have to actually put any of this stuff. Like, I don't have to go down here and do that, put it directly into the refinery. I can just double-click everything. The refinery is going to drag it out of there. So I can go right back to work. Okay, well, apparently I missed the uranium. Because there's no uranium right here. So I'm just going to do some free mining here and see if I can't find it. I mean, cobalt's useful. It's in motors and everything else like that. There's stone right there, so I doubt it's that way. Hello, autosave. There we go. I'm going to need iron, that's for sure. Cobalt for the motors again. Where is that uranium you said was down here? I feel like I'm lied to. I was lied to. I All right, let's go ahead and drop down and pick this stuff up. And all I'm doing now is holding down the T button. And that allows me to just kind of grab everything as it immediately looks at it. Uranium. It says it's right here. All I see is cobalt. I don't see any uranium. Thankfully, you don't really need a lot of uranium. But I mean, that's really annoying. That whole cavity is excavated and there's no uranium here. Because I would have already had uranium. Silver. Wait. Is this it? I think I found it. Yep, here it is. Ah, yes, the black gold. We have found oil. It's hiding in the silver. Okay, so I was lied to. It's just not as badly as I thought. All right. So let's go ahead and grab some of that. I don't need much. There we go. Just make sure that in this next pass, I'm going to have some of that uranium. There we go. All right. So, yeah, let's go ahead and go back up here. I'll throw that uranium in here. And, yeah, we're good. So you just move it from here to here. And that's it. You now officially surviving. You can be as completely independent as you want. You can just go nuts from this point. And you don't have to worry about anything. So I'm going to go ahead and get some more cobalt, because that's actually really valuable. I'm surprised at how easy it is to find right now. Normally that's a lot harder to find. Oh, and nickel too. Nickel's good too, because you need that for motors. So I'm going to make a beeline towards the nickel here, and just kind of pick everything up as I go. And if you're wondering why I'm not picking up every scrap, it's because I really don't need to. I mean, I really don't. Apparently there's no gravity in here. Oh well, doesn't matter. You know, I think I'll just go that way. I just need to back up a little, because I already got uranium. Like, you'd think I don't have enough uranium, but really I do. I have more uranium than I'm ever going to need again for, like, a while. You don't need much. So I'll just pick up what I have here. Autosave. Thank you. And yeah, that's really it. I don't think I really need anything else in this location. I should back up and get some of that nickel. All I mean, the silver is good because I'm going to need it for a... I already have a med bay. A reactor. You need silver for reactor components. I think that's really it. I don't think you need silver for anything other than reactor components and medical components. I don't think you even need them for radio components or detector components. But it's good to have extra of anyway. You never know. You never know! You never know! Alright, inventory full. There you go. Need to back up a little bit. Okay, about here I think is where it shall be found. Let's go ahead and kind of do this number. That's cool. All right. Get on here. Nickel. Still that way. Alright, that was close. Let's go ahead and line that up, just for efficiency's sake. Awesome, okay. I can go ahead and crank this up now. Because it really doesn't matter, I have uranium. Nickel! Nickel is very valuable. If you can get nickel and cobalt together, at least for me it is, because I like batteries and motors and anything that's like really complicated uses cobalt, nickel, and platinum. So those are the ones that you want, and gold. You want gold. That's actually the next thing I'm going to be after here in just a second. Actually, is that platinum? No, silver. But yeah, if you're ever wondering like what you're looking at, platinum kind of looks like silver, magnesium looks like ice, and iron is like a shiny, like brownish color, like a copper. But this stuff here, nickel, looks more like dirt. So if it looks like a matte dirt without shine to it, it's nickel. If it does have a shine to it though, it's iron, and that's what you need to always know. So inventory full. Let's go ahead and fly on out of here and. That's a lot of nickel. This early on. I think that's more than I'm going to need for a while. So I think I'm going to go find some gold now, and then I should be able to build just about anything I want. I got enough silver for anything. Ah, autosave. I hate you. I'm going to turn that off. Okay. Next episode, we'll turn that off. Alright, yeah, I'm gonna go find some gold now. So where's some gold? Oh, my light was on. I swear that gets duller and dimmer with every patch. There we go. Gold. Found it. Found lots of it. I can't see anything. There's even some surface gold over there. Oh my, there's found lots of it. So the hardest thing most people have when they begin space engineers is flying this ship. And it sucks. It's a really it's really easily crashed. This ship as like the worst, but that's good. I like that. I think there was more surface gold down here. I think so. Let's try this. I kind of want to go inside the asteroid. Can't remember where the entrance was. Oh, no, we're saving again. Yeah, I'm totally turning that off. That's getting annoying. I forgot how annoying that was. I turned it on for this episode because I wanted to make it to where if I ever screwed up, I had to live with it. But I think I can just, you know, do that on my own rather than require this. Oh, hey, look. Oh. Oh, there's uranium there too. Uranium and gold in the same spot. I guess I'll go ahead and take this. There we go. Because I could use more uranium. And believe it or not, you do need stone. If you're going to build reactor components, you need stone. And I have the concrete mod in this one because I like it. It's a good mod. The models are pretty good. I like the way the blocks work. It's a really good mod. So, I mean, I have outlets for that kind of stuff. But then that kind of happens later. But my goal in this one is really to do, you know, I want to build a cool station. Because I'm not really a station guy. I like building ships. So I'm going to try to build a station, but I might completely lose focus and build a ship. I like mining equipment, so I'm going to have like a lot of mining kind of vessels. And I haven't really done a lot of pirating. I mean, I have. But I haven't really done a lot. And no real reason for that other than I don't know, it's not fun for me. Just, it's not. But hey, you know, whatever you guys want to see, let me know. Because then it kind of gives me something to do. And then you get to see what you want to see. So, win-win. Alright, think I got enough gold. Grab some more of that uranium. Precious. Yeah. Because this is pure uranium, I don't have to worry about muddying it up with silver. The only problem when you're mining for uranium is you have to be very careful to remember where you came in. I have actually lost myself in uranium before because it absorbs all of the light, so you can't see anything. So you have to be like careful. Like right now, I mean, if I'm in the shadow, no idea. Like one trick is to mine next to another thing like this, so you kind of have a reference point. You can kind of see the lighter material next to it. And also, like, every now and then you can hit some of the lighter material and it'll go down there and settle next to it, so you could see all that uranium you've been mining. Uranium is actually one of the more dangerous things to mine, just because of the fact that you can get lost and then die because you can't find your way out, because everything is the same color. I mean, it's fun for that reason, but at the same time, it's really annoying that I can't see anything with this headlight anyway, and it's even worse when I'm, like, kind of a little rant. But yeah, 3,000 uranium. I'm not gonna have any problems with production. I think I have enough where I can even start building my base. That being said, I think I'm gonna go ahead and end this episode here. I've got everything that I need, so there's kind of no point to it. So I guess I'll just kind of this will be the first episode. And I'm going to go ahead and probably do a little bit more recording, get a couple more down there, but that way you can give me your kind of feedback and what you want to see, what you think of everything, you know. That way you can kind of see where we're at and where we're going from here. And by the way, I just found this this skin here, and this is the Black Maze skin on the workshop. It looks like it was started by a Worn Miner or a Worn Captain or something like that. I don't remember which skin that was, but by Tartaros, I believe. But this skin was made by, I believe, somebody else. I just got it, and I can't remember the guy's name, but it's a really cool skin. I like how it's kind of a mix of both. It's got a little bit of utility, a little bit of that darker kind of like rustic leather look, but at the same time futuristic. That's really cool. So, I don't know. I really like the skin. I'll probably end up using it a lot. And Black Maze is a pretty cool YouTuber, and I'd check him out if I were you anyway, because he's got some pretty good content up. Actually, pretty much everybody on here. So, I mean, check out Morellibus, check out Captain Jars, check out Black Maze, check out Brad Fusion. All of those guys are really cool. All of them do a lot of work. I might be missing somebody. If I am, I apologize. But those are people I watch on YouTube, and I really like their shows. And, I'm going to see if I can actually kind of jump in here and do this, because I've been wanting to do this forever, and I've been waiting for my friend to join me, and he's not doing it. So he's in Japan right now, and when he can, we'll do this. But and it's really mostly my work that's getting in the way, because I work really weird hours. But anyway, guys, thank you. Let me know what you guys think, and hope you like the new intros and everything else like that. Hope you like the new microphone. I got a new microphone. It's a blue microphone, and I like how it sounds a lot. I've got that in the mixer and everything else. I'm putting a lot more money than I'm getting out of this in my YouTube channel. So if you guys can help me out in any way, like, favorite, subscribe, all that stuff, it would really help me out. But anyway, guys, thank you. Have a good one.
All of them. Oh, shit! Daddy's a noob!